So I heard you like shortcuts. Well, here's round two of shortcuts that you requested. And we're going to do some advanced shortcuts using third-party app Pushcuts, which can send notifications based on different triggers. I'm going to show you how to trigger a shortcut with an NFC tag, double tap to lock your screen, and some shortcuts that will toggle things like hotspot and Wi-Fi. All right, first up is to create a shortcut that will lock our screen when we back tap. We'll hit the plus button to create a new shortcut. And this is pretty easy because lock screen is actually a direct step right here in shortcuts. If I search for lock screen, you'll see that action right here. I can tap it and add it. And that's literally the entire shortcut. You don't need to do anything else. Let's title this something so it's obvious. We'll call it something like tap lock screen. And now all we have to do is go to our settings. And remember, back tap is in accessibility. Go to touch. Scroll all the way down and you'll see back tap. We can turn on double tap and you'll see all your shortcuts are going to be listed down here. Remember, we called it tap lock screen, so we can just tap that, and now a double tap on the phone is going to lock the screen. Let's test it out. Boom, double tap, and it locks. All right, next up are some music actions. Now, this viewer was asking for Spotify actions, but unfortunately, Spotify has not made any shortcuts actions available at all. Really unfortunate. But if you do want to do some Apple Music ones, there you have plenty of controls. I can go for music, and you'll see all these different options, like playing different playlists, finding music's current song. Let's say you just want to create one that plays a specific playlist. Here I'm going to choose the Play Music action, tap there, and then you can have options to choose just a specific song or an album, or just go to your library and then Playlists. And let's choose our Brahms Classical playlist. Hit the plus icon up here to add all the songs, and that's all you need to do. You can expand that menu to either shuffle the playlist, repeat, and if I press play on this shortcut, it'll start playing that playlist automatically. Now, one other cool action we can add, maybe you already had some songs playing, you can actually clear the up next queue. So here, clear playing next, I can put that at the very top of the shortcut, and now it's gonna remove any songs that were in my playing next queue, and then play the playlist I choose. Or you can do things like add to playing next, maybe it's a song or an album, and for an action like this, we should add a get playlist. So we can choose to get songs in, let's tap one of our playlists here, and then when we tap this variable, we can choose this playlist action, and it will add songs from that playlist to our up next queue. We can even choose it to be next or play later on. All right, next up is a shortcut to the haptic settings. Now, unfortunately, there's no action to adjust the haptics here in the shortcuts directly, but we have our handy URL schemes. And so I'm gonna search for the action, open URL. We can select that. This is gonna be a one action shortcut. And the URL we're gonna use is prefs colon root equals sounds. Unfortunately, that's as far as you can get with the URL setting schemes, but I will put the link down in the description again that shows you all the different URLs you can use to adjust settings. The next shortcut is to automatically send a photo to a specific person in WhatsApp. Now, WhatsApp actually has lots of shortcuts actions, which is great. I'm going to choose the select photos action. I can choose to include all kinds of media. I just want images. I don't want to select multiple, although I can toggle that on if I do. Now, after that select photo action, I will need to use the WhatsApp send photo command. So send photo via WhatsApp. If I click play, you'll see the photo picker come up. I'll choose a photo and you'll see now I'm over in WhatsApp and I can choose to send it to any of my groups or individual contacts. Unfortunately, the send message command, which will automatically choose a contact, won't let you send photos. If I try to do that, I'll hit play. I can choose a photo again, but then you'll see it actually stops. It wants text in the message. So you can only choose to send a photo, and then you'll have to select the contact over in the WhatsApp app. Now, if you want to send a message directly via iMessage or from your iPhone, here you can choose to send a message with the photo and to a specific person all at once. See, here I'll choose to send the photo that I select. I can choose one of my contacts. I'll just type one in. And now when I run this shortcut, you'll see I can select the photo, and you can see it will send the message with the photo. I don't need to have a specific action. It'll just send the photo, and then I can click send right there. I can also expand this and uncheck show and run, and that will send it automatically without any action on my part. This can be photos, text, location. You can include lots of different options in this shortcut. If you have a question or more requests about what you can send via messages, leave a comment below this video and we'll do that in the next request roundup. Next, this person wanted to run a shortcut whenever you click a HomeKit button. I'll go to my home app quickly and go to one of my buttons. Here in the studio, I have several buttons here. I'll go to my Acara button. Let's say I want to do the single press. Now, typically you can add or remove scenes on the button press. And if I tap that, you see I have all my scenes, I have different devices. But if you scroll to the very, very bottom, you can choose to convert this to shortcut. Now it will have the action or scene you chose there previously, but I can X out of that and now add multiple different shortcuts actions when I press this HomeKit button. Now unfortunately, run shortcut is not an option. So you can't just create one shortcut in the Shortcuts app and then choose run shortcut for your HomeKit buttons. Whatever steps you want to run, you actually have to choose it all here in the home automation. Now you don't get all the options either. Like if we wanted to send a message with a photo or just send a message at all, those options aren't available in this kind of HomeKit button setup. These are the apps that would support something like a HomeKit button push, but it's very limited compared to regular shortcuts. I fully agree. I wish you could just run a shortcut with a HomeKit button, but it doesn't look like that's something Apple wants you to do right now. All right, next up is integrating PushCuts. PushCuts is an app, both free to download and there's a paid subscription, but I didn't need to pay to enable what I'm doing right now. All I wanted to do was to get a notification after a contact sensor has been open for a certain amount of time. I've shown you before how to do this with the Acara app with specific Acara sensors, but that doesn't work with other contact sensors like from Eve or Philips Hue. So what I did here is I can create a new notification in PushCuts by clicking the plus button. I can customize what the notification is going to say, and I really don't need it to do anything else. I really just want the notification when this gets triggered. You can see this is what the notification looks like from PushCuts, and the only thing you need here is this URL. This webhook URL is what's going to trigger that notification on your iPhone. That's all you need to do in the PushCuts app. Now I'll go over to Shortcuts, and what I did here is create an automation. So when the contact sensor on the mini fridge opens, then it's going to do some shortcut steps. The first thing it's going to do is actually wait, because what I'm trying to do is see if the door is left open. So it's going to wait 60 seconds once that contact sensor opens. Then I have an if statement. If the mini fridge is still open after 60 seconds, I'm going to put that PushCuts webhook URL in a get contents of action right here, and that's going to send me the notification. I'll see that the mini fridge is open and it's been open for at least a minute. You can change the wait command to be longer or shorter, and if the contact sensor is not open or if it's closed, this is going to do nothing. So if you open the mini fridge and then close it within a minute, nothing happens. But if you open it and it's left open past 60 seconds, PushCuts will send me that notification using this webhook URL. Really useful if you want to get a contact sensor, get a door left open notification, but you don't want to have to use the third-party app to do it. All right, next up is to have a template. When you create a new note with a shortcut, it'll have everything from that template already pre-written. Now, when you look at all the different notes actions, there's no duplicate note options where you can have a template in notes that it automatically duplicates. So rather than starting with a note action, search for text. Here I can add a text box, and here's where you can put whatever template for note you're wanting. Let's say it's name, address, phone number. You can type as much or as little as you want in this text field. Then that can be the template that serves for new notes. Now I'll search for the Apple Notes app. Let's create a new note, and I can choose create a note with whatever I typed in that text box. I can also choose the folder that it gets created in. Now when I run this shortcut, it's going to create a note with that template. Now keep in mind that first line is going to be used as the title for the note, and then whenever you type for the note will be underneath that. But that's a way to have some kind of template for your note. If I change that first line to be template note and then run it, you'll see this is the note it creates and it can have that text already pre-populated. The other request was, can you lock a note with shortcuts? And that's not an option. You'll actually have to go to the physical note and then tap the lock option to require your iPhone passcode or Face ID to lock a note. This next shortcut is to turn off the hotspot and Wi-Fi, and this viewer was wanting it to be an automation. Now, unfortunately, there's no get Wi-Fi or hotspot status. So I'm gonna start this with a menu. We'll do choose from menu, and let's do hotspot on and hotspot off. Then I'll have to search for individual actions. Hotspot is an action supported, so we can set personal hotspot. We'll put it under the hotspot on, and this is turn hotspot on. Tap on the far left side, and you can duplicate an action, which makes it a little faster to build it. And now this will be turn hotspot off. And he wants to turn off Wi-Fi at the same time. So let's search for Wi-Fi. I'll choose set Wi-Fi and we'll have Wi-Fi turn on. I can duplicate it. And this is turn Wi-Fi off. So this will be one shortcut. I'll choose either hotspot on or off. And if I choose on, it'll turn a hotspot on and Wi-Fi on. And turning off will turn them both off. Then you can put this on a back tap if you want for a quicker access or on your home screen. All right, next up, a great way to trigger shortcuts is with an NFC tag. This is an inexpensive NFC tag. You can get packs of 20 or even 50 just for like 10 bucks. And let's go over to the automations tab in shortcuts. I'll hit the plus button and here I can choose NFC as the trigger. Then you'll see scan as an option. So let me tap scan, hold the top of the phone near the NFC tag, and then it'll program that tag. We'll just call this table NFC for now. And I want it to run immediately, no confirmation or notification. This way it just runs real fast, no notification to see. I'll start with new blank automation. Now I can build an entire shortcut right here within the automation, or I can choose the run shortcut action. Now I can select one of my pre-made shortcuts. Let's do that tap lock screen shortcut that we made, and I'll hit done. Now whenever I scan this NFC tag, it's gonna lock my phone. Let's try it out. Boom, scan the NFC tag, and now my phone is locked. That can trigger any shortcut or number of actions you'd like, and you can place these NFC tags in your car, in your house. Just to give you an idea, I have one NFC for in the car. It'll play a certain playlist or podcast. I have one on my desk tray that will set a filming scene. And I have an NFC tag in the family room that sets all my movie watching scenes, my Hue light bulbs, all just from scanning that NFC tag. All right, this next shortcut, I'll just put this link down in the video description. You can grab it there. But this is a quick shortcut that will give me the word count from any selected text. It'll get the clipboard if I don't have anything selected. And one of the actions in shortcuts is just to count the words and then show it in Quick Look. For instance, I can go to one of my notes. I'll select all the text. I can go over to the share option, hit share, and you'll see word count is one of my options here. I can move it up to the top or favorite it. And when I do that, it'll just show me a quick word count for whatever text I have selected. Helpful if you need to be under a certain amount of words or characters, and it works anywhere you can select text. These last two shortcuts, I'll put links down in the description. This one is to get a list of links of apps. I have some pre-done text here, but you can choose to get it from the clipboard or share from text you've selected. And what this does is take each search term, splits it by new lines, so it'll do a new search with every word. It repeats with each item that it split, and then it finds an app in the App Store. I will choose the one I intended to, and then it will format what I choose. Then I can copy it and paste it in something like a YouTube description. Let me cut this down a little bit so you can see what it does. But if I hit play, I can choose what apps I intended, and it's searching the App Store with the terms in that list. It'll format it, and you can see I get a nice formatted list with the app title and the link to that app. That'll go to my clipboard, and then I can paste that in something like a YouTube description for a video like the one I'll link right up here, which is 42 widgets you'll love, and the links to all those apps I did with a shortcut like this. And finally, this shortcut actually gets an app artwork and then formats it with those rounded corners. So if I play, I can choose to search for an app. I'll choose Ferrite, the app I use to edit all my podcasts with. It searches the App Store. I choose the app I intended. It gets that artwork, and then it actually saved it to my photos. You see, there's the artwork right there, and you can do this for multiple apps in a row. I'll put links to those shortcuts so you can just download them down in the video description. And if you have more shortcuts requests, I'd love to hear them. These follow-up videos are really fun to do, and I hope you find them valuable. So leave those comments below, subscribe to the channel before you go, and hit that like button. And I'll put that video about the 42 widgets I think you'll love right up here. And if you want to learn more about shortcuts, maybe this is the first video you've seen me do on shortcuts, well, I have a Shortcuts 101 with 7 easy shortcuts to get you started, and then, you know, fall down the rabbit hole of all the shortcuts videos I've done in the past. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.